It's like 10,000 years. And you're just sitting in all this white. It's like this horror story. It's like you're just sitting in this white room for 10,000 years.
Are you relating to time?
Yeah, you're something about time we haven't understood, and it's just like sitting there. And then when you come back into reality, it freaks you out so much it kills you. So that's something to look forward to.
I think time has got just a look at the time left.
Think so.
Imagine that. If we keep running races, it's inevitable, because I don't believe there will come a point where nobody would break the record of somebody, the last person. And inevitably, that means that you would get here to there in no time at all.
Right. Oh, I see.
That's inevitable. And when that happens, it's too late. We'll be at a point where time ends. And there will be no time. And it's probably been that way all the time. So time to me is like, it's all here at one time.
Yeah.
It's just dimensions that we slide through according to where our heads are at.
Right.
And we have different people, different friends, different situations.
Right.
All that is in the same space. And some people kind of run into it all at the same time. So you hear them talking to themselves.
Right.
And they're probably talking in between dimensions. And I believe they're going, something like that is going to happen. When the aliens come here, they're going to really disturb us a lot.
That is, if they're not already here.
But most of them, I'm pretty sure that we are aliens, that we are clones.
That, in other words, so we were maybe seated on this planet somewhere?
Yeah. Probably for the third or fourth times. That's why some of the memories we have, the deja vu, and all that stuff is. Somebody should remember how they did the pyramids. And we all have
And
we all have the notion that they went that way.
Right. I think about UFOs. A lot of people don't talk about the other. They always think it had to come, which maybe at one point it had to come from some distant star. But I think when people said they see this stuff, which may be real and not interdimensional, it's been here. It's just it goes in and out of shift mode where you can't see it, and then sometimes you can't see it.
Well, I don't know if you've heard the stories, but Boots and myself experienced something. And we didn't talk about it for 12 years. It was like, okay, it happened. Ain't no sense telling nobody because
it was like a UFO sighting.
We already looked like idiots anyway when we dressed.
Right.
So the fact that we usually are under influence, but we weren't this time.
Right.
You know, we ride down the street in Toronto, and daylight, we see a light straight down the sky. Now, first of all, the first thing that occurred to me is to see the light in daylight.
Right. Like, more intense than the daylight itself.
Yeah. It's strange. He didn't say that. I said that. And we got to the spot where we both saw it there. I'm looking around. He looked around. And he said, you saw that? I said, yeah. He said, what was it? I don't know. So we kept on driving.
Yeah.
And that takes about 10 minutes to get from where we saw that to our exit. I lived in Mississauga. We got off the highway 401. Now we're driving down a road that takes about 10 minutes.
Right.
About two blocks in front of us. The same thing came right down through the trees and in the middle of the road, about two blocks ahead of us.
It was the mothership.
No, listen, they stopped here, hit the road, it splattered like sparks. And we was listening to the radio. Johnny B. Good was playing on there.
Right.
They're talking about setting up the time capsule.
Sagan's the Viking.
Yeah,
Voyager.
They talk about
Chuck
Perry. And neither one of us, we just come through the border, so we ain't under influence.
Right.
So, and just as I mean, for the knob to turn it on, turn it down, to see what was.